So I'm with Amy Franko, who is a specialist in business-to-business selling. She's a strategist. She's a consultant. She's a keynote speaker. She's an author. I first became familiar with Amy's writings over the last 6 months when I came upon her blog, which I thought was really good. I then bought her book, The Modern Seller, which appeared a couple of years ago and is amazingly timely. She talks in it about some of the things that bankers in particular need to take to heart in terms of adapting to this changing environment. But Amy, welcome. I'm glad you're with us here.
Ned, thanks so much for having me here today.
So I have to ask, when you wrote the book, did you realize that you were timing it so well?
You know, I can't take credit for that. That sometimes it's better to be lucky.
I thought it was great strategy.
Right? We'll go with that. We'll say it's great strategy.
Well, which is one of the things I want to talk to you about, because you talk about the fact that for people to be successful today, you know, they have to be able to not only learn new things, but they have to be people who can think systematically about the sales process, for example. And one of the things you focus on is strategy, which is an area that I think anybody that's involved in business-to-business selling needs to take seriously, because it's different now. It's harder in some respect. We got more people that are on the buy side. We have, you know, challenging kinds of situations that we didn't necessarily always deal with before. So how would you frame the discussion around the importance of strategy?
Yeah. So I work, as you mentioned in my intro, I work a lot with professional services, mm-hmm. and you know, for all of the rigor and the process and the strategic thinking that I see go into products and services and solutions, many times there isn't that same level of strategy when it comes to how are we going to sell, how are we going to win new business, how are we going to grow the business that we have. And so that was the catalyst behind the strategic selling program that I designed, is to help bankers, help those selling professional services B2B to think strategically, which is to think several steps ahead, to be thinking big picture, but to also give them a track to run on in terms of process, to give frameworks that help you think about not just what's right in front of you, but to think strategically and also think about what's the next step in winning this client business or continuing to work with this client.
Because it's in a lot of business development, it's about keeping the momentum going. And, you know, there's some things that, you know, sometimes are obvious, but we don't always think about them, which is, you know, the analogy of, you know, sometimes we're playing checkers. We really should be playing chess. We've got to think a couple spaces down the road. You know, one of the things that's interesting for bankers, and I think it's probably true of others, we're missing, or many of us are missing the contact that we used to have through events. Because people used to view events as part of their strategy. They were going to meet somebody at an event, whether it was a trade show or maybe a chamber meeting. Those don't exist the way they used to.
Right. So when I'm working with my clients and we're thinking about their book of business or maybe their sales territory, whatever that may look like for them, if you envision your particular book of business or you envision a client, there are four things that I believe that you need to have and you need to be thinking and acting strategically about. You need to have really strong business intelligence about those clients.
Absolutely.
What's happening in their business, not only today, but into the future. And everyone's crystal balls are a little murky right now. So part of our role is to help navigate. So we have to have business intelligence. We have to identify and earn access to the right relationships, both within those clients and even within our own organizations and industries sometimes. Mm-hmm. We need to be able to make or propose a compelling case for change. Mm-hmm. We need to propose solutions, ideas that really help them move forward. And we have to be compelling about in that. And then lastly, we have to be able to strategize and earn commitments all throughout the process. If you get those four things right, you are going to exponentially increase your odds of earning that client's business and also keeping it and growing it for the long term.
Yeah, I think that's a great framework. And it's very consistent with what I've seen the top performers in banking do. They're able to access good intelligence, because there's a lot of intelligence about industries, certainly a lot more about companies that we can find. You can certainly find out a lot about the individuals that you're calling on, you know, tools like LinkedIn, which you've been acknowledged as one of the top voices on sales in LinkedIn. I congratulate you for that. But, you know, they're tools that you have to utilize to move your, to keep the momentum. But you also have to, you know, your final point about strategizing continuously, to me, involves thinking about people, you know, people on the client side, but also your colleagues, your partners. It also involves thinking about perhaps bringing into the discussion the other parties to the ecosystem. You know, in the banking industry, our clients have accountants, for example, or they have insurance agents. And to the extent that bankers begin to build their network around the kind of advisors that their clients have, everybody will win.
You're reminding me of a story. I have a professional services client, and there's someone that I coach within the mm-hmm. firm, and he is masterful at building relationships with his ecosystems, like you describe. And I think of those as strategic alliances.
Yeah.
Who are the people in your ecosystem? They aren't competing with you. They are complementary to you, and you can work together to better serve your clients, win business, continue, and serve them for the long term. And one of the things that he does that's just really smart is his firm puts out a lot of different pieces of thought leadership. Mm-hmm. And he shares that thought leadership with those strategic alliances. So his bankers, his other advisors, things like that. And what that does is it makes them look really smart with their clients. And then in turn, what it does is it starts to bring referral business back to him just by keeping that ecosystem alive and sharing great thought leadership.
I think that's fantastic. And there are a lot of great ideas out there, great articles, great books like The Modern Seller that Amy Frank has written for us. So I hope people take advantage of it. And Amy, I hope we get a chance to talk again soon about some of the things that you're continuing to do for your clients.
Yes, definitely. We'll make that happen.
Great. Thank you again.
Thank you.